Well, he insisted, you know, Dick Silbert, his production designer, was one of the great production designers of the period, said Warren would help you whether you wanted him to or not, and he wouldn't take no for an answer. Ashby hated doctors, didn't want to be operated on, and Beatty sort of forced him to, and they had a big falling out.
How different is Beatty's method of operation when he is doing a film than, say, Robert Redford, who he considers a competitor, or any of the other really top actors?
Well, Beatty was known for, putting his actors through the ringer. He took take after take after take. I mean, he was famous for doing 20 or 30 takes, 40, sometimes as high as 50 or 60 takes of even very simple things where there's no dialogue, like somebody stirring a cup mm-hmm. of coffee. And he was extremely meticulous and extremely perfectionist, as opposed to somebody like Hal Ashby, who was a former editor and believed that the movie was made in the editing room, or Robert Altman, who who was like, you know, I don't know how to, this very loosey-goosey.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah. Dee Dee Allen is a major component to Warren's success.
Well, Dee Dee Allen was, again, one of the great editors. I mean, one of the things that was wonderful about Warren was he was not afraid to gather people, the best people in the business, around him. You know, he didn't have to be the smartest guy in the room, although he probably thought he was the smartest guy in the room, and he may have been the smartest guy in the room, but he got Elaine May, Robert Town, Buck Henry, Bo Goldman, best writers of the period, Dee Dee Allen and some of the best editors of the period, and the best cinematographers of the period routinely worked with him, and it strengthened him, and he wasn't afraid of them.
And he would pick their brains. He would pick their talent and incorporate it to himself. Do you think he will ever make that film on Howard Hughes?
Well, you know, it's hard to say. It's sort of like, do you think a comet is going to hit the Earth?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah.
He's been trying to do it for years. It's one of those projects he's been nurturing, you know, for 20 or 30 years. It's perfect for him. There are many, many, personality parallels between Beatty and the late Hughes. And I think for him it's humiliating to go out on a movie like Town and Country, which is so mediocre. I mean, I think Beatty has a very, and rightfully, a very, high opinion of himself. And I think he should go out on a good movie.
Yeah, because when you read what you write here about Ishtar and about his friendship with Elaine May, and how it all, it just exploded in a way. There they were in Morocco, it should have been Greenwich Village.
Yes, I mean, he was doing her a favor, and it's one of those, be careful what no good deed goes unpunished stories.
Yeah.
You know, she was very helpful to him on Reds, and he thought, you know, Elaine has never had a good producer, I'm gonna produce this movie for her, I'm gonna protect her, and then everything went south.
Yeah. And there was no way to get out of it. I mean, it was, the more they dug, the deeper the hole became.
Exactly.
Yeah.
It's his Vietnam War.
Now, you had done the film on the early sort of people of the Wild Bunch, of Dennis Hopper and Peter Fonda. Warren was of a different ilk.
Well, Warren was friendly with both of them. He was in a movie with Peter Fonda, Lilith. And he was friends with Hopper, but Warren was a little bit older. I mean, he was born in 1937. He was less of a rebel. I mean, he was a rebel, especially in the early years. But he learned very quickly to manipulate the system instead of beat his head against the wall, which is what Dennis Hopper did for a long time, or Peter Fonda did for a long time. He was, in a certain way, smarter than they were about how to get what he wanted. He was very, very good at it.
Well, this is a great book for anyone who loves film and wants to read about Warren, but even more about Hollywood and how the film system works. Thank you very much, Peter. Great reading.
Thank
Will you,
Connie. Will
you autograph my book?
Absolutely.
Thank
a pleasure.
You. And if you'd like to know what else we've been reading, visit me on the web at www.conniemartinson.com. You can read our columns from the Beverly Hills Courier. You can even link in to Claremont Graduate University Peter Drucker Institute, where there are 400 or 500 of Connie Martinson Talks books with people like Peter Biskin and even Barack Obama. They're all there on their digital web. But meanwhile, support your library, because libraries are where it all begins. And heaven knows there are some great books written about Hollywood, even Bud Schulberg's last book. But don't forget, read Star. It's a terrific book about our era and films and Warren Beatty. We'll see you next time. Thank you very much, Peter.
Thank you, Connie. A pleasure.